ask everyone to stand after me. I was glad when they said unto me.
I was glad when they said unto me.
Let us go into the house of the Lord.
Let us go into the house of the Lord.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
All ye lands.
All ye lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Come before his presence with singing.
Come before his presence with singing.
Please remain standing for the program.
Amen. Father God, we thank you for just being in your presence one more time, God. We thank you for just being here with our bishop, celebrating this anniversary one more time, Lord.
Amen.
We thank you, and we just ask you to continue to touch our bishop down throughout the week, Lord.
Amen.
Give him the strength that he needs so that he can continue to celebrate anniversaries, giving us your word, Lord.
Yeah.
We ask you to continue to touch our deacons, our missionary saints, our friends, especially our mother in the church, Lord. We ask you to touch those that are sick right now and can't be here. Touch those that are on their way here, God. Touch those that may be traveling and can't be here, but Lord, touch them and make them suffer, Lord.
Amen.
We thank you for those that are going to church throughout the world, Lord, celebrating your son Jesus.
Amen.
Most of all, God, we thank you for your son Jesus.
Amen.
And we have a wonderful time in your name today. We pray. Amen.
Amen.
Scripture reading.
Today's scripture, verse 1, is coming from 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, the 12th and 13th verse. The New Living Translation. Dear brothers and sisters, honor those who are your leaders in the Lord's work. They work hard among you and give you spiritual guidance. Show them great respect and wholehearted love because of their work, and live peacefully with each other. Hebrews 13 and 7, the New International Version. Remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. 1 Corinthians, the 9th chapter, the 14th verse, New International Version. In the same way, the Lord has commanded that those who preach the gospel should receive their living from the gospel.
Amen.
Happy 17th anniversary to our pastor, Amen. Chief Apostle, Bishop John D. Green.
Yeah.
We love you, and may God continue to bless you.
Yes. Amen.
say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen again.
Amen.
Truly, truly, we glad to be back in the house of prayer.
Oh God.
Amen.
Amen. We glad to be back on the pastor's anniversary.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say God is good all the time.
God is good all the time.
And all the time, God is good.
And all the time, God is good.
I'm truly grateful to be here for a lot of reasons. Somebody say, what's the main reason?
What's the main reason?
The main reason is that I'm back with the Lord.
Yeah.
Love God, love God, love the church, love my wife, but I love God more.
Amen.
Got to.
And until you get to that point, you're wasting your time.
All right.
Because Jesus told us. What's the first command? You must love the Lord.
Lord thy God with all.
Thy God with all my heart.
Mind,
both body, soul, strength. And then Paul picked it up and said, you know, that's your reasonable service.
That's right.
You think you're doing God a favor.
No.
See, we think that. We get down here and we get these big ideas of ourselves. Self is something. You got to watch yourself.
Yes.
And you begin to think that you got should have special treatment or special privileges.
Oh, no.
But I believe that the book taught me, and this great man taught me, and my father taught me, it said one key point. In the beginning was God. And then it goes on to say that God created the heaven and the earth. Now the $64 million question is, who is this God character that created everything? Now we got a lot of people in the Bible, but the main person in the Bible is God. And until you know who God is, you don't have a clue.
Right.
You can do whatever, you can go whatever, you can even say it, say whatever. And you can be born up in the church and still don't get it.
That's right.
It's all about God through Jesus Christ. So we're going to dial it down, back it up.
Hallelujah.
I want to say happy anniversary to this great man, my brother.
Yeah.
I love him. And he deserves to be honored today. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
He deserves to get a little glory today.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
He deserves to get a little recognition today.
Hallelujah.
Somebody please say amen.
Amen.
Because remember, he's been here, working in the vineyard, putting his time in.
Yeah.
You
know, we used to say, put your time in. Paydays coming up. So we're going to give him honor today, give him some praise today.
Yes, Lord.
The man is going to come and say a few words. And we're going to get this wonderful program started.
Yeah. Amen.
So I'm going to do a portion of this song. Dr. Boom and I guess Dr. God is over here too. We're gonna do a little bit of this song and then we're gonna move on. And I believe he's been good to the pastor.
Yes, yes, Lord, yes.
Real quick, I think the brothers up, let's just talk just a minute more about this great man of God.
Yes.
I'm so proud of him.
Yes.
Because you know, I lost my way, he was still right there.
Yes.
Praying for me.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
No.
Yeah.
Calling my name for God.
Yeah.
You know, when you lost, you really don't get it.
No.
You ain't got a clue.
No.
Because you still think he's about you.
Yeah.
You don't understand.
Yeah.
The book ain't about us.
Right.
The book is about God.
Help.
you say that?
Yes, sir!
Ask my wife, I woke up early, I was excited. I ain't been excited in years, y'all. I said, you got to sleep, she woke up, said, what's wrong with you? I ain't even told her, I'm so excited. Can't wait to get to church. Oh, Lord, hallelujah! I can't wait.
Right.
Bishop always told us, we're not exempt.
No, we're not.
don't worry about it. Just keep your faith in God.
Oh, yeah.
That's the really key.
You'll be right.
The devil realizes one thing. He don't have that second chance.
Right.
His motto is,
come on,
stop.
Stop.
Don't let him stop you.
Uh-huh.
It's just, we love it here.
Uh-huh.
We enjoy it here.
Right.
This is the best ever.
Uh-huh.
But when you get out there, you got to deal with it. You got to deal with it.
Lord have
mercy. The human part of it.
Uh-huh.
You got to kind of regroup.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I'm going to tell you, a lot of times, I have to regroup sometimes.
Uh-huh.
People make you angry in a minute. Let's see. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth.
Uh-huh.
Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness.
Come on.
Uh-huh.
That's what you can't let up. Can't let up.
Uh-huh.
How hard it come.
Yeah.
Because guess what? Every day ain't going to be Sunday.
That's right.
And I'll tell you, I had a rough week.
Uh-huh.
I had a rough week.
Me too.
But God has been good to me because the deal is, every day ain't going to be Sunday. You got to have your faith.
Amen.
You got to get that corner. You got to find that little spot.
Come on, brother.
That gives you back that strength. Because I'll tell you,
down the week
I was a little hurt.
Uh-huh.
But you know, when you feel that when you're ready to come back to church, you know,
right.
That's when you get your strength. Because for making me laugh, making me smile.
Uh-huh.
You know, sometimes you got to get tough on me.
Yeah.
I appreciate that. Like Ben said, he don't sugarcoat.
No.
And that's the way to be.
Uh-huh.
You know, I thank God for it.
Uh-huh. Right.
Like the sign said out there, greater love.
Uh-huh.
Right.
We love as we can.
Right.
Don't let nobody take your love away.
Right.
Sometimes we all say wrong things.
Yeah, sure.
We might do wrong things. But
love.
Never, ever, ever lose the love.
No.
Love got me for 2 years of marriage.
Uh-huh. Right.
Come on.
I'll be talking junk too.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead, Blake.
Get it, Mother.
You can't give it because it just went over
you.
No, I'm just blessed are the merciful.
Yes.
For they shall obtain mercy.
That's
it right here. You know, if you could be merciful, if you could show love.
Show love.
I read further on.
Uh-huh.
When I think about
come on.
What did he say? When Jesus was on the cross. He said, Father, forgive them.
Yeah, they don't know what they know.
Now, here's somebody killing the devil.
Right.
Forgive them.
Uh-huh.
And then that other young guy that was on your side.
Yeah.
Jesus told him, this day,
you will be with me.
Right. Now, that's love.
Yeah.
But you got to remember, that young man humbled himself. Part of life is dying.
Yes,
not
going
around that.
No,
and I know I'm going to have to cry. We said goodbye to so many.
Yes,
but it's okay. We're still here. We're not giving it up.
That's not going up
because the deal is Bishop had already told us.
Yes,
it's strong.
Yes,
but not as him.
But not as him.
We can't run from it.
Right.
And I just thank God for that because it lets me know. I'll get somewhere and start crying in a minute.
Yeah.
But in front of everybody else, I got to be strong.
Uh-huh.
We all can't break down together.
That is right.
Somebody got to be strong.
Yes.
Come on.
God is good all the time.
Oh, help me. Help me.
Blessed are the pure in heart.
Uh-oh.
For they shall see God.
Uh-huh.
That's what I want to do.
Yes.
All right.
I'm going to see God for myself.
However he sees fit.
Yes.
I just want to say, Lord,
let your
will be done.
Yeah.
I just want to be able to make it. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Man.
Forgive me for all whatever I did.
Me too.
You know, see God. That's the key.
Let me see him.
That's the key. Made us in his likeness and
Lord.
I mean, that's favor right there.
Yes.
A lot of people don't realize. They think, you know, you got to have so much.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, sometimes, you know, the wants, but you got to remember your needs.
Right.
I would love to have the best of the best. But
guess
what?
Right.
I do got the best when I'm
looking
at it. Right.
Yes.
Oh, God, Lord. That's what it is.
Yes, Lord.
People want to live like the Jews.
That's right.
And guess what? The Joneses just fall off.
Uh-huh.
All the time.
Yes.
And they look for you to pull them up.
Uh-huh.
I don't know no Jones.
Blessed are the peacemaker.
Uh-huh.
They shall be called the children of God.
Amen.
Right there. Here it is. Every Sunday, breaking it down, letting you know the worldly situations of the ups and the downs.
Uh-huh.
And he wants to make it. 9 out of 10, he makes it out.
Uh-huh.
When you get to that serious point, don't no hiding. There's no running. Just,
just peace.
Be thankful. You know,
yeah.
A good shepherd.
Come on.
Thank God for that.
Yeah.
Blessed are they which are crucified. persecuted for the righteous, for righteous sake. For the righteous shall inherit, for the righteous, for the righteous sake. There is the kingdom of heaven.
Lord have mercy.
So, you know, that's the key. I mean, that's what we're here for, righteous
Make it happen.
That's it, amen.
We got to have it. We just got to have it. Righteous, you know, like they said, what is that saying about the prayer of the righteous? You know what I mean? The righteous, you got to have, you know, when somebody's for you, a lot of people feel, I come to church, this and that. But you got to remember, people praying for you.
Yeah.
And you can't see that. You rather wait for somebody bring you in here with a bullet than you. Or you handicapped. Or you sick, and now you want prayer. Prayer can only do but so much. When you you had the ear to listen.
That's right.
And you ran from it.
Ran from the truth.
But one thing about that, once again, he's merciful. He'll nurture you through it, but you got to go through it.
Yes.
That's the must.
That's true.
Let's see. Blessed are ye when men shall, what's that now?
Revile.
That was a tricky one.
Go ahead.
Revile you and persecute you.
Come on.
And shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake.
All that.
And that's basically it. That's the way it is. Oh, you're supposed to be a Christian. Yeah, I'm supposed to be a Christian, but I ain't going to let you run over me.
Right.
There's only a far line, you know. And they beat the horn, they beat the finger, and stuff like that. I don't have time for it.
Come, Lord.
God is good all the time.
That's all the time.
I know each and every last one, all of us go through.
You're right about that.
A lot of times, you know, I want to call people, but sometimes, it's what's that old saying? It's the saying, pray. If you pray, don't worry. But if you worry, don't worry. And that's it. If you don't worry about it, what's the sense? Pray, and then when you talk to Bishop give you some good words.
Come on.
Go with it.
Help you.
Go with it.
That's right. Get through your situation.
Rejoice and be exceedingly glad. For greater is your reward in heaven. For such persecute,
the prophets
shall
which were before you.
Where come before you. Alright, so that means other folks that came before you. I used to love that thing that we used to sing a long time ago. We used to do Flowery Beds of Ease. That's the key. That's the key. I mean, there's no free ride here. And don't, like Ben said, don't sit on it too long. Don't wait. Don't wait. I'll pray that the Lord bring me in this day. That's what I'm fine. But I'll tell you.
I promise to you.
And coach, I thank God. It just gets to me sometimes. Where my daughter came from.
Oh, Lord. Thank God.
Where my wife was going through.
Yeah.
It's a lot of stuff. The key is a lot of people say, why is he not showing no emotion? The deal is, you got to be strong.
Yeah.
So, Bishop, years and years, over and over, you're doing a great job. Brought us thus far. I know you're going to bring us all the way. Because we're not going to let them.
We're
gonna help each other.
We're
gonna know each other.
Yeah.
We're gonna forgive each other. In Jesus' name, pray for
me.
Yeah.
Hey, come on, we gotta move on, y'all. We gotta move on, y'all. Come on, we gotta move on. This is your time. Give some love. Deacon Desmond, here you go. Come on.
Hey, come on, Deacon. Yes. Come on,
Deacon. I want to give honor. Brother, let's say that Jesus Christ.
Yes. Oh,
Bishop.
Yes.
Deacon, see some friends.
Oh, yes.
I'm happy to be here today.
Yes.
Of the anniversary.
Yes.
Thank you for this privilege.
Oh, and yes.
Yeah.
Take your
time.
Beautiful,
beautiful. Thank you. A little bit about power and glory.
Okay. Go ahead now.
Come on.
Let me give God glory.
Uh-huh. Amen.
The Lord gives His people strength.
Uh-huh.
We need to give God glory.
Amen.
He will give us blessing.
Uh-huh.
The Lord is powerful.
Uh-huh.
He got the power for everything.
Uh-huh.
Glory to His name.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Give Him glory.
Uh-huh.
He will give you peace.
Uh-huh.
Because you were strong.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Give unto the Lord,
uh-huh.
Holy Mighty.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Give unto the Lord,
yeah.
Glory and strength.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Give unto the Lord,
come on.
Glory to His name.
Uh-huh.
Glory, glory, glory.
Glory unto His name.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Worship the Lord,
come on.
In the beauty of holiness.
Uh-huh.
Jesus.
The voice of the Lord,
mm-hmm.
is upon the water.
Uh-huh.
God of glory.
Uh-huh.
The Lord is upon many waters.
Yes, yes. Yes.
The voice of the Lord is powerful.
Uh-huh.
The voice of the Lord is full of glory.
Amen.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, Jesus.
Take your time.
And I'll say,
uh-huh.
The blessing you got given from the glory.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it
come on
scream and yell when you vote for all game?
Go ahead.
Why is it we scream and yell when you vote for cancer?
Uh-huh.
And function?
All right.
Now.
Lord.
But when we come into the house of the Lord,
uh-huh.
We remain quiet.
All right.
Why? Why?
Why?
Uh-huh.
Man.
Okay, sure, your team may win.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
You might walk away with your winnings.
Uh-huh.
You might have a good time at a concert.
That's right. Uh-huh.
But from
Jesus.
You may scream,
mm-hmm.
good,
mm-hmm.
ill,
uh-huh.
by the name of the house of the Lord.
All right.
Let it give Him glory.
All right.
These are the things we gotta do.
Uh-huh.
Jesus. My Lord.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Give you happiness.
Uh-huh.
Give you strength.
Uh-huh.
Give you joy.
Yeah. Yes.
Peace.
Yeah.
Holiness.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And salvation.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So I don't know about you, but I know that my help comes from giving God the glory.
All right.
All the glory. Happiness.
Uh-huh.
Happy anniversary.
All right.
Put time for the desert kingdom.
Yeah.
Yeah. and knew nothing else was here but God.
Right.
And after God created heaven and earth, everybody praised everything else except God.
Yes!
Come on, Jim.
You figure it out.
Yes.
So we're going to move on. Thank you.
Love it.
Thank you. God bless you. So we're going to move on to another brother. Another good brother.
Yeah,
uh-huh. Been here a long time.
Yes.
You gotta give credit for credit to you. This is a good brother
here. Uh-huh.
This brother's always showed me love.
Yeah.
Always.
Uh-huh.
Supported me.
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. I'm honored to be here.
Yeah.
And bring this young man up.
All right.
Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Deacon. I'm out here with Black. Jimmy Lane.
Brother Desmond, my man over there, Brother Deacon Blake. And the good words that came from my man here, man. Blessing that he has come back and asked so many good things to say about his
vision.
All that he's been through, he's not ashamed to say because he's come back into the Lord. When you come back into the Lord, he said you got to be free of your spirit. You got to be open minded and clear.
Yeah.
Thank God for that.
Amen. Yeah.
So my word is letting Jesus be your hero. As a child, we thought of Superman and Batman as our superheroes. We use these figures to look at people we want to be like.
You are. Right.
Then as we grow up, we have other people like leaders, famous actors, or our families to be like to encourage us and give us something to strive for. To be like that. To be like that is all fine. But in anybody is truly a hero is Jesus Christ. All that he has done for the world is something only he can do. He's a healer, a peacemaker. He's a deliverer. He's a provider.
Yeah.
In Philippians 4:19, King James. But my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory.
Come on.
By Jesus Christ.
That's right.
Amen.
There is nobody greater than Jesus. For me as a superhero. And unlike Superman, who has powers limited by kryptonite, only soars through the sky, but so far Jesus, powerful and endless, and is sending from earth and back to heaven. Batman only knows his Batmobile. And being able to throw punches. Beat the bad guy. But tell me what battles has Jesus lost?
Come on.
It was Jesus that was born in flesh. And only died for the sins of the world. With all power. It still was in him. But by his stripes, by his blood, we are healed. Let us know that our flesh will die, but our spirit will live forever. If we serve him, let him be your hero. He will always be there and never leave you for sin. He's our guide and refuge in the midst of the storm. In Matthew 11:28, King James, come unto me all who labor and our heavenly name, and I will give you rest. Both Superman and Batman had to be changed into their costumes.
That's right.
And become characters.
Come on.
Jesus doesn't change.
No!
He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. There's nothing that Jesus can't do because he is my superhero. I thank God for all that he's done for me. He's my superhero because he can raise people from the dead. He heals the sick. What can Batman or Superman do? We say Superman flies through the sky. But my Jesus can walk on water. That's what the bishop told us. That's what he's saying to us. That's why we should come out to Jesus.
Come on now.
Be our superhero. We out there in the world like Ben says. So we don't have him as our hero. We have to accept him in our as our Lord and Savior. All in. Says we gotta be all in.
Halfway.
Everybody know it's not time to play.
No!
Everybody know that he's been there.
Right.
You can come back
and right.
Time is running out. And I thank God for my bishop. Every Sunday.
Come on.
Through whatever he's going through.
Jesus
is our superhero.
Right.
He's the one and only that can help us.
Right.
I know we say
come on.
Our parents get older.
Right.
We look up to our parents because they get up and go to work. So when they're down and out, they still get up and go to work. It's Jesus who's helping them to get up and go to work. He's first. Because without him, our parents wouldn't be able to get up and go to work.
That's right.
Even more than they've been through. Superman and Batman wouldn't be if it wasn't for Jesus.
All right.
So where are we backstepping and going from one to the other? We should be for them.
That's all right.
You know, without him, none of us would be here.
All right.
We come into the church and we thank God for everything.
Yes.
That Jesus is our
Savior. All right.
Jesus is the one and only.
Woo!
And God says he's first, the last, and the beginning.
All right.
So I thank God for everybody in there. Stands firm to what he's doing.
All right.
He doesn't backslide, doesn't backstep, he doesn't
No.
He comes straight ahead like a bullet.
Right.
Shoots it, it's for you to take it.
All right.
And go on with it.
Thank
God for my bishop and thank God for each and every one in the church. You know, because I thank God that he's my superhero.
Jesus
stood on the cross. He died in the crossroads.
Yeah.
He was nailed. You know, he could have said, you know, I got it. When he put those nails through his hands,
Lord,
and through his feet and raised him on the cross, I thank God for that because he said he's there to take our sins from us. He's there to take all the
sin
that we've been through. That
Yeah,
he says, come unto me and leave it all at the cross.
All right.
He's going to do that for
you.
I mean, our parents will take the pain. You know, a mother's love is forever, you know.
So right.
Say, I can heal you. I can put a band-aid on it.
Right.
No, but it's Jesus who's going to heal it.
Yeah. All right.
Jesus who's going to bring it all
back. Come on.
All right.
I'm putting a band-aid on it.
Right.
But it's Jesus who's going to bring it
all back.
Right. He's going to make it all better. He's going to heal it from the inside out. That song that teaches it from the inside out.
All right.
And it's true from the inside out because Jesus
inside.
Can do it.
Wow.
I thank him for that.
All right.
It is an honor to be able to stand each and every one of them because Bishop gives it to us.
He
wants to accept it.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
And to be able to say something that he has given unto us.
All right.
You know, Bishop, what you do is not in vain.
No.
Amen.
What you do, we are hearing it,
accepting
it, and carrying it on.
Yes. All right.
Thank you for that.
All right.
And she said, Father, I'll go.
Hallelujah. Yes.
What do you mean you won't? Except you told them, you know what? Before Abraham, we showed Abraham. You know what? Before Abraham was, I was.
Jesus
Christ. You thought you'd been 50 years old. What are you talking about?
Right.
I'm that bread. That came down.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Bread.
What
is he talking about? You don't know who Jesus is.
Yeah.
Jerry just told you who he was.
All right, there.
He's the only hero.
Yeah.
Super. When you get your last breath, you can't call Batman. We just laying in there. And the doctor said we can't do nothing else for him.
Right.
You can't call Superman.
No, you can't.
You can't call Obama. back.
Yes.
Welcome back home, brother. Welcome back home.
Yeah.
To that living God.
Yeah.
So you honor to my brother-in-law, my bishop.
Yeah.
It's green.
Amen.
Happy anniversary.
Oh,
yeah.
To me, I want to wish you a happy anniversary every single day.
Yes.
Not just once a year.
Right.
Because I know the type of man you are.
Right.
Spiritually and just an individual.
Yeah.
With the cloth on or without the cloth,
yeah,
you're still the same man.
Yeah.
So I appreciate you, and I just want to say thank you for everything that you've done for me in my life.
Yeah.
You know, outside of God and Jesus, you know, I can say that you have been a super inspiration and an inspiration to me to stay and keep Jesus focused in my life.
Yeah.
So thank you for that. So happy anniversary again. I love you with all my heart.
Amen.
And I thank you for your things, for everything that I do. I appreciate you so much. Also, would be remiss if I would say, I got to give honor to my wife.
Uh-huh.
I love this woman so much.
Yeah.
You know, and I know everybody says, you know, why I shout so much, because I can really say I have a lovely home.
Oh,
it's peaceful.
Right.
I love my son.
Right.
And when we're at home, you know, you might get mad because somebody said something wrong.
Right.
But there's so much love that flows in our house.
Yeah.
Sometimes I say my wife is married to my son.
Right.
Because every time I turn around, it's like, no, mom, me and mom want to go do this, we want to go on, we want to go on, we want to watch this. Or we want to go in my room, me and mom want to go watch this. It's never dad, you want to come watch it? It's always what me and mom are going to do. When it's time to eat, mommy, what you want to get? If I say what I'm going to get, he's not going to say I'm going to get that.
Right.
Mommy, what you going to get?
Right.
It can be totally opposite of mine. I'm going to get what you going to get.
Right.
Now, he can get something. Me and him can come up with the same idea. But, mommy, what you going to get?
Right.
He done changed his mind.
Right.
Now, you get up. I'm left all alone. Now, I got some fun.
Right.
But that's why I shout so much, because I can truly say, God, you truly been good to me.
Yeah.
And I really love coming to church.
Yeah.
And I shout because I enjoy God and I enjoy Jesus being a part of my life. Because I know how He guides my life on a daily basis. Don't get me wrong, I do get upset, but I know God guides me in the right direction. To make sure that I don't get out of hand. Or He puts the people in front of me to make sure that when I do slip to try to get out of hand, somebody's going to be right there to shut me back to right where I need to be at. And so I thank God for that. You know, truly, I just want to thank God because
Come on.
The words that came from the brother today were really inspiring. It's really beautiful to hear the brothers talk.
Yeah.
And it's good that there's a lot of women in here, but there's some young men here get to see the older men come up here and expound on their lives and how God and Jesus has helped them and guided them through their lives.
Yeah.
And then helps them to be able to do what they do throughout their lives.
Yeah.
While they're trying to raise their families.
Right.
So I truly thank God for the words that came from Deacon Jerry, Deacon Rodney, and also my brother Ben, and also Deacon Desmond.
Because
God has really shown that He is really doing some touching. Because we're welcoming to the family not just brother Ben, but also Deacon Desmond.
Right.
So you know, when you see the works of God drawing people into His house, you know, that's a good thing. And I think anybody that's saved, you should be feeling good when you see God draw somebody back in. Because you know what they've got.
Yeah.
Because you got the same thing.
Yeah.
And if you got that love, then you want somebody else to get that love. So I thank God for that.
Amen.
So today, my topic today is the devil is always stressed.
Come on.
But Jesus overrides it with His blessings.
Yeah.
And that's why I shout, because Jesus blesses me every single hour. Every single minute. Because as long as I stay with Him, He blesses me. Because He always brings to my mind the good things that He has always done for me.
All right.
So as I'm making my journey out my house to work or wherever I'm going, He's always there because I keep Him there. I don't never shove him to the side.
That's right.
I keep him there.
Right.
As long as I keep him there, I know the devil's going to stress.
Right.
As long as I keep him there, Jesus is going to override that and going to bless him.
All right.
So I try to make sure that I have him with me every minute of the day. I say my prayers before I go to sleep, because I know when I go to sleep, I need him to watch me.
Yes.
So when I wake up, I even thank him before I roll out the bed.
Yes.
I thank him for just waking me up.
But externally and internally, you know, I'm going to say research shows that it was Luke. So we know it's Luke. So, but in the book of Acts, the main purpose of this particular book was three things. One was to demonstrate the unstoppable progress of the Bible. Because a lot of people weren't really believing and going a total different direction, a total different direction of what the Bible was doing. So Luke had to come in and redirect them in the way where they need to be in. To understand the progress of the Bible.
Yeah.
Come on.
And in that, the whole purpose of that was Luke has, he seeks to show how the gospel moved from its Jewish roots in Jerusalem outward into the Gentile world.
Right,
so
right.
That's the good thing about it, because we all know that Jesus came, he came for the Jews first.
Right.
But they had it all.
Right.
But because they really wasn't really trusting and really believing like that,
that's
God said, okay, gave us an opportunity.
Yeah.
So that's why I say God, I thank Jesus for that, because he did come to them first.
Right.
And he could have just stayed with them.
Right.
We would have been lost.
Right.
But we, being Gentiles, I thank God he brought it into us.
Yeah.
So that was the purpose of that. That's one.
Right.
And two was to present a history.
Right.
You gotta have a history.
Right.
If you don't have a history, you don't know where you're going, you don't even know where you came from.
That's right.
So if you're gonna talk about the Bible, this gotta be a history of where it comes from, and why you talk about it, and why you praise it, and why you do what you do from the words of the Bible.
Oh, yeah.
So it has to be a history.
Yeah.
And in it tells us that the finding of the church, the founding of the church, so that's the purpose of the history, because you need to find out how the church was founded. You need to be able to spread the gospel. And the beginnings of the congregations, different types of congregations. That's why you see so many different types of congregations out there, because the word of God has spread around.
Yeah.
So you have to have some history to understand how all that got started.
Right.
So, and not only that, it started so you can get the whole evangelistic effects of the apostolic pattern.
Right.
So that is really important, because you've got to have a history of where you come from. If you say you're going to be a Christian and you're going to follow the Bible, you've got to have a history of why you're a Christian. We all have our history of being black, of being black and brown. We know where we come from. So, but you, if you want to say you're a Christian and follow Jesus, you've got to have a history.
Right.
When people are talking to you, when you're talking to your family, you can talk about why you are who you are. And why the history of who you are when it comes to your faith.
Right.
So, and the third is to give us a defense. You got to have a defense.
You need it.
You know, like I said, the devil's going to always bring stuff to you to stress you out. So you got to have a defense. And with this defense, we saw these guys, because there's a purpose of this, because there was a record of Christian defenses made both from Jews and Gentiles, with the underlying purposes of confirmation for believers and the conversion of unbelievers.
Right.
So you gotta have that whole defense to make sure, because there was people that were believing, and then there were people that were not believing. But if you're gonna talk to believers, how do you bring somebody in?
So
you gotta have a defense to be able to convert somebody that don't believe.
That's right.
Right.
Now, like Ben said, it's good. He has a testimony.
Right.
So he can talk to you about where you are in the world, not being with God. Because no matter what you were doing, his sins or him being out there might have been longer than yours or might have been deeper than yours. But no matter what you were doing, because you both were not with Christ, if God would came and took you both, you both would have been in the same place.
Exactly.
So that's the key. He has a testimony.
Right.
God allowed him to stay out there that long.
Right.
Amen. And Ben don't make the time in the cross, I don't make my time in the
cross.
The Christian don't make the time in the cross, but God already got our departure scheduled. So we have to understand that if you know that God has a departure scheduled for you, you don't know what it is.
That's
all. Take a look at those people in Buffalo, prime example, in Buffalo. Some of his workers in the store, they had no idea that yesterday somebody was going to end their life.
Right.
But I tell you, you knew, God knew that the life was going to end yesterday.
Yes.
He even knew how
people say, but God so loved me, so that people see a lot of things you don't understand.
Right, in the wrong way.
You're talking about the wrong thing.
Right.
So the whole thing is, you just need to worry about yourself.
Worry about
yourself and worry about if you want to be right. Or worry about what's going to happen when God said, your time is
up.
Because your time is set. And you have to make sure where you are when your time is set. And like Ben said,
You're speaking.
And Jesus can over all that pride and bless you.
Yeah.